Democrats in America were put on earth to do one thing: drag the ignorant hillbilly half of this country into the next century.
Adolf Hitler, like Barack Obama, also ruled by dictate.
Mr. Romney has delivered some world-class stupidities during this campaign.
He is organizing Hitler Youth.
Who is this clod, you must be asking? Well, his name's Mitt Romney.
Mitt Romney is the Ron Jeremy of political campaigning. Every day he's in a different position.
His fundraiser was staged by a man who conducts sex parties on Long Island.
You don't have any care for these people. What are you talking about? We've got it on tape, Governor. We got it on tape what you think of these people. Don't come out here and pretend you care about old people because you met somebody at some campaign event.
Maybe Jesus was punching Obama in the face. I don't know. That may have been what got him distracted a little bit. Maybe a little spiritual bam to the face. I'm not sure. I'm not Jesus, so I'm not going to say that's what happened. But I'm not saying that either.
That's what they should be saying to the Republicans. Shut the fuck up while I slap your face for making noise. Now pass the cap and trade law, you stupid bitch, and repeat after me, global warming is real.
They're jealous. The Democrats are so jealous of Tea Party they can't see straight.
The teabaggers, the one thing they hate is when you call them racist. The other thing they hate is black people.
These losers at Occupy Wall Street, what are they protesting?
Backward to Jim Crow, or backward to the breadlines of the 30s, or backward to hanging union organizers, or backward to the trusts and the robber barons. Result? The Tea Party. Vote backward. Vote Tea Party.
Meanwhile, the Time Person of the Year is the guy who takes the dump on the squad car down in Wall Street at the Occupy movement.
They will come for you and drag you into the streets and kill you.
I'm sorry, I don't speak bumpkin.
But they don't know what they're protesting. They're brainless, they're brainwashed.
There is no, absolutely no parallel between the peace-loving, tax-paying, hard-working people of the Tea Party movement and the anarchist, poo-flinging, Marxist monkeys of the Occupy movement.
We know, we tend to forget it, but we've known since 7th grade civics class that a free and independent, truly independent, fiercely independent when necessary press is the red beating heart of freedom and democracy.